Marcia Strassman is one of those actresses where you just know that you've seen her before. Whether it was television, the movies, or would you believe even the radio airwaves. During her life, Ms. Strassman made a memorable impact as an entertainer that one could instantly identify with. Sure, she was pretty, but she was also down to earth. Someone that if given the opportunity, you could actually talk to, perhaps for hours on end. Her big break was on ABC TV's sitcom, Welcome Back, Kotter. It's hard to believe now, but way back in 1975, this show, which was based on characters from lead actor Gabe Kaplan's stand-up comedy routine, well, it was perceived as controversial and edgy because, as critics of the show would say, it celebrated and glamorized a group of kids that were in a gang. Of course, as time went on, it became clear that the sweat hogs weren't much of a threat to anyone, except maybe the institution of higher learning. Marcia played Kotter's patient, kind, and understanding wife, Julie. At first, her role seemed to be that of a listener. She would listen to Gabe talk about his uncle's Herschel or some other relative, and of course, help him work through whatever the problem was that week. It was a good role because it was a consistent paycheck, but truth be told, it didn't really stretch her as an artist the way that she would have liked. Since the late 60s, Marcia had been full of ambition and promise. She'd landed a recording contract and released a handful of singles before deciding that her main love was acting. By the way, you can listen to a few of these songs on YouTube. I put a link in the upper right-hand corner to The Flower Children. It's my favorite of her songs. It's a fun little hippie anthem that sadly never got the attention that it deserved. The first role that I really remember Marcia in was as nursing Margie Cutler on MASH. It wasn't a one-shot, it was a recurring role, and she appeared in 5 or 6 episodes during, well, early in MASH's run, and did a great job as a nurse who seemed more than just a little smitten with Alan Alda's Hawkeye Pierce. After that, she would appear as a guest star on the anthology series Love Story, and Police Story, and Marcus Welby, MD, before landing the role that really defined her in the 70s. Yep, whether she wanted it or not, Marcia Strassman was Julie Kotter. She played that role to perfection, even when she wasn't all that pleased about what the script writers were having her say and do. Alright, let's take a quick time out here, folks. Does anybody remember these dolls? Oops, I mean action figures. If I recall correctly, Mattel also sold a classroom playset where you could have hours of fun creating your own wacky Welcome Back Kotter storylines. Truthfully, these Sweat Hog dolls weren't on my Christmas list. However, I did want this darn thing. Sadly, my parents, for most of my childhood, were anti-lunchbox. If I wanted to bring lunch from home, well, it was going to be in a brown paper bag. Alright, back to Marcia. As time rolled on and the cast and creative team prepared for what would be the show's 4th season, Marcia became even more vocal about her dissatisfaction with the show. In fact, in a 1978 article in People magazine, Strassman talked about her difficulties working with Kaplan, who she said she just couldn't seem to connect with. He was either hot or cold, and she never knew which Gabe she would be working with that day. In the article, Strassman says that she'd like to see the series come to an end, and apparently viewers felt the same way, that the show's ratings tanked, and in 1979, ABC decided to pull the plug. Of course, this wasn't the end of Ms. Strassman's career. She continued to find work in both television and movies. I particularly loved her in the 1989 Disney movie Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. Heck, anything with Rick Moranis is all right with me. And around the same time, Strassman had a recurring role in the 21 Jump Street spinoff Booker. I think she was the best part of that show, which starred Richard Grieco and aired for a single season on Fox. After that, there were lots of other roles, especially on TV. But the best part of this story, at least for me, is that long after the cancellation of Welcome Back, Kotter, Strassman and Kaplan, well, they finally connected. They reminisced about their turbulent times on the show, and they were just finally able to build a genuine friendship. This is the stuff that makes me happy, folks. I love it when people learn from their past and move forward in a positive direction. This next part doesn't make me happy at all. In March 2007, Strassman was diagnosed with advanced breast cancer. She talks about that experience in her book, Life with a Side Order of Cancer. And in that book, she steps outside of her own world and offers up advice to others who might be suffering in a similar way. Sadly, along with the breast cancer diagnosis came the realization that it had also spread to her bones. This horrific news did not stop Marcia, however, from celebrating with most of the Welcome Back Kotter cast during the 2011 TV Land Awards, where the show was recognized as a television sitcom that made a lasting impact on a generation of viewers. I think Marcia looks great in this photo. Her smile clearly demonstrates that she was able to shake off the stress and worries of her health for at least one evening. In 2014, Marcia passed away due to complications from the disease at her home in Sherman Oaks, California, surrounded by those who loved her. She was 66 years old. All right, one final pick of Strassman is Julie Kotter. Yep, she had a lot of roles, and this one may not have been her favorite, but it was mine, and this is how I like to remember her. So that's it. Please share your memories in the comments section below, and while you're at it, please click on the thumbs up icon, and why not consider whether or not you'd like to subscribe to my channel. I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.